Hello, welcome to another interesting topic of strategy planning, campaign planning and media budgets in the ever-changing world of advertising. The expert is Simrat Gulati and I am Charu Pamar. Let us now try to understand how the process of advertising moves ahead. Let us see what actually goes into the planning and executing of an ad or a set of ads. So, the topic for the today is strategy planning, campaign planning and media budgets. The client hires the agency for executing its advertising task. The agency gets a compensation for getting the work done. The client gets the best service and the talent of professionals by hiring an agency. How does an agency get hired? Or how does a client hire an agency? The usual method is for the agency to present their strategy to the client. This is usually done in a competitive situation where many agencies are vying for the business. The strategy and the ideas that make the best impact on the client get selected and that agency get hired. The whole process is called pitching for an account. Here the account refers the business from a client. That a company or brand or firm is an account of the agency. Pitching is the process by which the business is obtained. It is a process of competitive selection of advertising agencies by companies. When firms want to outsource their advertising duties to the agency, they call for a pitching wherein all shortlisted agencies present their thoughts on how to take the brand forward. The most appealing presentation finally gets selected by the client to handle its brand communication duties. What all services does the agency provide? The agency provides different kind of service to the client. The creation and making of an ad, the scheduling and insertion of ads in the media, marketing, promotion and research facilities, ideating and planning for the brand or the company in the long run and the short run. These are all the basic functions. From all these, the one important function that the agency provides is the long-term thinking and planning for the brand, and that's called account planning. The short-term objective and goals of advertising are thought out based on long-term plans. An ad or a set of them is not planned in isolation. It is a result of detailed strategizing and planning. We are spending money and effort to promote our ideas, so we need to be sure that what we plan will achieve results. We also have to be sure that what we are doing is correct and is required for the brand. That is what account planning function is, and it involves more than just ad making. It's to do with long-term strategizing and planning. To do this, we follow a sequence of steps and arrive at the task to be done. This is what is strategy planning, which is result in the final campaign being planned. Where are we today? Before we think of an ad for a brand or an idea, we have to understand what is the present situation and what is happening in the market plan of the brand. This is the situational analysis. Then we have to move from the marketing to the advertising function. Where does the brand stand in the market today? Who are its competitors? What is the strength of the brand? What is the weaknesses? What are the opportunities available? Who are the consumers? What are they like, their choices and preferences? From this emerges, what we need to do next is our communication or advertising. Where do we want to be? The situational analysis will tell us what we need to do and where we should head. What is the final goal or destination? How to reach there? Now we decide what to say in the ad or how to say it so that we reach where we want to. That's how the content and creative aspect gets decided. Also, which method or what media are we going to use to reach our target audience? Let us take an example and see how this strategizing works. Suppose a company is introducing a new flavor of soft drink. This soft drink seems suitable for children with the kind of flavor and taste it has. Firstly, we have to see the situation in the market. Where are we today? We have to think of a name suitable that will appeal to the children. Is this a new flavor for the people, or is any other company already making it? What are other options available to the consumer? What sizes of packaging does the consumer prefer? What price will be suitable? What name will be good? Where do we want to be? This will make us decide on the product and its launch. For the launch, we have to decide who is the product meant for. What is the objective of advertising? Here it could be meant for children, and the objective is to make them aware of the new brand. How to reach there? We know we have to do heavy advertising since it's something new and people are not familiar with it. So, we need to create ads that would be eye-catching and memorable. Maybe use humor or a celebrity or a jingle.
Chhe! Dhikkaar hai hum par. Polio ke booth pe itne kam log. Kab tak apne ghar baithe intezaar karte rahenge aap? Kab tak apni zimmedariyon se muh modte rahenge? अरे भाई मां बाप तो बच्चों के लिए क्या क्या नहीं करते. दो बूंदें जो आपके बच्चे को जिंदगी दे सकती हैं, उसके लिए आप चार कदम नहीं चल सकते. 5 जनवरी और 9 फरवरी को बूथ पर जाएं और बच्चे को दवा पिलाएं. चलिए.
वी नीड टू एडवर्टाइज मोर फ्रीक्वेंटली एंड थ्रू अ मिक्स ऑफ वेरियस मीडियाज. द एम इज टू रीच आउट टू द मैक्सिमम नंबर ऑफ पीपल ऑफ आर काइंड एज फास्ट एज पॉसिबल and in as many ways as possible. So we choose methods and media accordingly. In our case, TV and radio programs for children, promotions in mall and schools would be suitable. We would like to reach out to large numbers, and we would see to it that we do not miss out people seeing the message. So what we have done is that we have made the advertising plan or the campaign plan, a whole set of strategies and activities for launching the brand. Thus, an ad plan would consist of ad or campaign objective, target audience, and segment. The objective here is to make people aware of the new soft drink. The target audience is children in the age group of 3 to 12 years. Children of families in upper income or upper middle income groups, creative strategy, kind of ad, message and content. The message has to have high attention catching ability and high recall. Since it's for children, then maybe we could use animation or a character, or the other option is to use a celebrity popular with children. We could have a jingle or a song and use AV media. Media strategy, choice of media, timing and schedule. Here we find that TV and radio seems to be suitable for giving the message. Programs and channels, we will have to select keeping in mind the habit of the user. In this case, it is children, so use channels targeted at children's and time slots which have programs for children's. Of course, the budget would also need to be kept in mind. This would be the broad strategy or campaign plan. The ad plan or the campaign plan answers, where do we want to be by the ad or the campaign objective? How to reach there by the creative and the media strategy? What our task now is determines the kind of money we need to spend, budget. That's what is the budgeting for advertising. The expenditures by the client would be on the following. Creating the brand identity like logo and pack design, letterhead and other signage design. Strategizing, ideating and creating an ad. Production of the ad, which would include shooting, hiring models and finishing. Media cost. The cost of buying time on TV or radio, space in print or OOH, out of home. The agency could charge on a job basis. There would be defined rates for designing and other work. Or the agency gets hired on a contractual basis. They are with the client on a regular or fixed compensation and will do work as and when required and get paid for each task also. Another method is the incentive-based method, where the agency's incentive depends on performance or goals achieved. It's a complex method of calculation and depends on various factors like sales, growth, and media commissions. At times, the agency is handling the entire work of the client and the media spends are huge. The agency gets a percentage of media spends as their commission, and these are such a large amounts that it covers all other costs. So the agency works on this commission basis. This last method is what is followed usually, and that's where we talk of media budgets. To give you an idea of this system, most of cold drinks companies are spending nearly rupees 100 crores each per year on the media buying. The agency gets about 15% of this as their commission. If you work this out, it comes to a figure of about rupees 15 crores earning for the agency. Cost of making an ad and other work involved would run into a couple of crores. The rest is the agency's earning. So when we refer to advertising budgets, we are talking basically about media spending or media budgets. Deciding on the media budgets is done in many ways, and it depends on the advertisers, his size and functioning, and also the task that is to be achieved. We have two ways of planning the budget. Number one, top-down method. Number two, build-up method. Top-down methods. As the name suggests, we break down the expenditures of the company and see what can be allotted to advertising, or we need to be allotted to advertising. So we have the following methods. Marginal analysis or return on investment, ROI. This method is based on the premise that sales and advertising is directly related. So the company will continue to spend on advertising as long as the marginal revenue yield by the additional sales is more than the marginal cost or additional cost on advertising. Or simply put, the increased cost on advertising is less than the increase in the returns coming in. It's a very simplified thought, as we find that the sales can get affected by many more things than just advertising. So to follow this method may not be ideal, but it's a good way of getting a rough estimate of what we need to do. Percentage of sales. This method uses sales as a base of determining the amount to be spent on advertising. A figure or an estimate is set, and as sales increase or projected sales increase, the spend is also increased. it works on the premise that profits indicate how much can be spared for spending on advertising, all you can afford. This method is used by small firms and companies who just allocate funds for various purposes, and what can be given to advertising is allotted to it. It's a simplified version of budgeting, as the role and effects of advertising are not kept in mind. The estimate could be grossly wrong. It's a method that works on the thought that yes, we must advertise and be there in the market, but are not professional enough to plan out things, nor we have the mean to do so. Competitive parity and share of voice. This is a good way of estimating spends on advertising. The idea is to have a presence as strong as your competitor in the market. So spend as much as they do to remain at par with them. Or if the market has many shares, then the share of ad spend should be equal to the share of the market your brand or your company has. For example, if your company has 25% share of the total market, then the kind of money spent on your ads should also be about 25% of the total ad spent on advertising for all the brands in the market. These methods are not very accurate as they do not keep the full impact of advertising in mind. Advertising affects revenues and sales, so the correlation has to be considered. Also, what your competition is planning for the future is not kept in mind. That's what brings us to the build-up method, which is objective and task method. Here, the objective of communication is defined. Then the task or methods needed to achieve it are listed. And then the cost of performing them is estimated, and thus the budget is decided. For example, if you want to increase your sales by 5% in a year, you may need to increase awareness of the brand by 20%. To achieve that, you need to use a mix of various media and promotional efforts to reach the target audience and to have the required effect. How much is that going to cost? That will be the budget required. Now, this budget may not suit the client. We would now adjust it with the amount that is affordable, or see the sales and determine the budget and see what can be achieved in it. So what we see that finally a combination of these methods would be used. This way the budget gets decided and all methods have their application and suitability. Today, what we have gathered from this lesson is the way the agency functions with the client to acquire the business from the client, perform the task for the account, plan for the brand advertising and communication, budget the expenditures on advertising and achieving objectives. That is all for the day. See you soon. All the best.